Hello and welcome back to SVSN. My name is Gerlif Weiss and I'm your show host. Let's get on to our first important story for seniors and juniors. Scholarships. One of our third reporters, Chance McNally, has a little bit more about these scholarships. Out to you, Chance.
Thank you, Garrett. Seniors, a lot of local scholarships are out right now, so here's a list of the scholarships that are out and their due dates. 4-H Scholarship, January 31st. Buckeye Rural Electric and Company, February 19th. Ohio Oil and Gas Energy, February 24th. OAPSE and AFSCME, February 24th. Rumpke, February 28th. Utility Pipeline, March 3rd. First National Bank, March 9th. Rotary Club, March 17th. Atomic Credit Union, March 17th. Minority Journalism, March 17th. Sode Foundation, March 22nd. J.B. Wilson and Garnett A. Wilson, March 31st. Zach Farmer Memorial, April 25th, and Ohio Problem Solving, May 31st. So seniors, get on the ball and get your scholarships filled out so you can get that money for college. Back to you.
Thank you, Chance. All right, guys, it is that time, one of my favorite times of the year, musical. One of our field reporters, Calum, has more on musical, and he interviewed some of the seniors. Out to you, Calum.
This week, I sat down with the lead of the musical and some of the seniors and had them tell me a little bit about their characters.
Hi, my name is Garrett Lif Weiss, and I play the part of Amos Calloway. He is the ringmaster of a circus that Edward works at. It is his first job. And I give him tips about the girl that he eventually marries. And throughout the play, I become one of Edward's good friends, and I return at the end of the musical at Edward's funeral. I also play the part of Red Vang, and he tries to kill General Patterson, but Edward kills me, so that's pretty much my part.
Hi, my name is Kennedy Meredith, and in our production of Big Fish, I play the part of Sandra Bloom. Sandra Bloom is basically the mother figure of the whole entire musical. She ends up marrying Edward Bloom, and she is just a sweet Southern belle, and Sandra and Edward meet a circus. I don't want to keep this one. Can we do it again?
Hey, my name is Ira Hableton, and I play the part of Edward Bloom in the musical. Edward Bloom is the main character of the entire plot of Big Fish. He starts out as in his teenage years, and he's out on a dare, and he eventually figures out that he doesn't have to be scared of what lies ahead in his future. So his entire life is devoted to making everyone his friend and never having to worry about the challenges that lie ahead of him. He always knows that he's going to get through. And as he tells his son about all of his adventures whenever he's older and he's sick, he tells his son about all these, and his son, Will, doesn't really believe him. So there's a little bit of a strife between them that works itself out in the end. Yeah.
Oh.
Thank you, Caleb. I'm so excited for the shows. You should come out and watch it if you don't have anything to do. And now we have a story. This isn't really a story, it's more of a fun little clip of life of a high schooler. And here it is. Move schools here, but that was a good story, very accurate. You, and that is all we have for today. I hope you enjoyed, and I'm going to send it off to the sports center team. Out to you, Gabe, Baden, and Ethan.
Welcome back to this episode of SVSN. I'm your sports anchor, Gabe Berkheimer.
I'm Ethan Crabtree.
And I'm Baden Ford.
And this is going to be an episode not like any other. We have got these great new things called Chromebooks, and they are going to help us get our first story. So how about we get a new story real quick?
Okay.
Yeah, let's do.
Football is our first story, as you can see here on our Chromebooks. The Piketon football team received academic All-Ohio as a team for the first time ever.
That's a big honor, buddy. That's a great honor.
That is a big honor. So Luke has a story on that. Out to Luke with the football team getting academic All-Ohio.
Thanks, guys. I'm here with Coach Gallion to ask about the award. Hey, Coach, I heard the football team got an award. What was it?
Yes, recently we were awarded the Academic All-Ohio Team. Mm-hmm. A very, very prestigious award. Goes not only doing a lot of work on the field, but doing a lot of work off the field as well.
Got to get those grades up. How did we qualify for it?
What I had to do, I had to take our top 22 of our top players and their GPA, the ones with the top GPAs from the first 9 weeks, and submit them into the state, and then they break them down, and if you finish in the top so much percent, you're awarded all-academic, all-Ohio. So, and the top 22 also had to be letter winners from this school this past football season, and it goes off the first 9 weeks of the grades. So we had some great students, had several 4.0s, a lot of 3.9, so I'm proud of what the boys did, not only on the field, but definitely in the classroom this year.
Okay, back to you guys. Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
Thank you for that story, Luke, and shout out to the football team.
Good job, boys.
Great job.
Gabe, I actually have a joke for you.
Well, I'd love to hear it.
Why was Cinderella kicked off the basketball team?
Why was Cinderella kicked off the basketball team?
Because she ran away from the ball.
Ha ha ha! Ha ha ha! Man, that was a good joke, Ethan.
Thanks.
You got anything to add, babe?
Hey, come over here and have one.
I do.
What do you call a basketball player that misses a dunk?
I don't know.
An alley whoops.
Oh!
Ha ha ha!
Ha ha ha! Ha ha! Well, guys, enough joking around. Let's go to our basketball story. We have boys basketball against Yenyoda.
With
Bryce Pearson.
Bryce Pearson.
So, out to you, Bryce Pearson.
Thanks, guys. The boys basketball team has two games this weekend. Friday night at home against the Southeastern Panthers, and then Saturday night, the all-day basketball track extravaganza against the St. Trace Pioneers. to see you guys there. Back to the studio.
Great story, Bryce, and a really good effort by the Plankton Red Streaks. I mean, that was, you know, it was a good team, and we fought right with them.
Didn't we? Game, heck of a game. I'm proud.
My heart was beating like this fast the whole time.
Silence. We have some important news here as the sports team of SBSN, don't we, Ethan?
Of course.
Don't we, baby?
Of course we do, good.
Why don't you guys give me a little more insight on what we're about to do?
A little more insight on, you mean our random padoodles?
Or random padoodles?
I mean, I can't wait for our random padoodles.
I can't wait either, Scott.
Well, why don't we go ahead and dive right in to SBSN's first random padoodle.
Out to us.
On this week's Random Padiddle, myself, Dr. Phil, will be interviewing Sassy Wigsy. So how have you been lately, Wigsy?
I don't see why you care, but I've been good. I ain't even gonna ask you how you been.
Well, I've been great. So what have you been doing lately?
You know, just cruising around, you know, hanging out with all my people. Don't worry about it. Don't matter to you.
Sounds very interesting. You have anything else to say?
No, I don't, Dr. Neil, I don't. What you laughing at? You got a problem? Catch me outside, how about that?
Well then, this has been your week's Random Padoodle.
Get that camera!
Well, that was our first Random Padoodle. I hope you guys liked it.
I mean, I thought it was pretty good.
I enjoyed filming it.
It was fun.
I enjoyed it.
Well, I think that was a pretty slam-bang finish to this episode of SBSN. So, I'm your sports anchor, Gabe Berkheimer.
I'm Ethan Crabtree.
And I'm Bane Fuller.
And to all you out there in the valley... keep it classy.